Morning, folks. It's a bit windy today, but it's the end of June, so I'll do an end of June allotment tour. First of all, get the kettle on. See you in a bit.
Dave at the allotment. Dave, what are you up to this
Hello,
afternoon?
Hello, welcome to Dave's allotment.
As it's a nice day to crack on,
to get the kettle on.
But I would recommend you look at his YouTube channel because he's genius.
Dave's allotment. Yes, that's what it's called.
What are you, everybody? Irene.
And I'm that kind of thing.
See you in a bit. Well, hello folks. Welcome to another episode of Dave's Allotment Garden. It's windy today, but it's better than what it has been. It's been chucking down for the past 3 days. Thunder and all that. But it's nice today-ish, so I'll be doing a little bit of a garden tour because there's a lot of things shot up since the last garden, like the allotment tour I did, which was 3 weeks ago or something. I know it feels weird not making videos every week, but I feel better as well. So thanks folks. Aye. So what I'll be doing today is, before I show you around, I've got a couple of other jobs to do. The other day I was here, and this is the one for you. I come up the main path, and I walked into to open my gate, and there was something like shoved in the door handle, and I was like, what's this? And I thought, I know what it is. And I was right. One of my subscribers has bought us a new flag. What are you trying to tell us, like? Something the matter with my old flag, is that? So thank you very much. I do know who it is, Lee. I found out. I had a little sneaky suspicion it was you with one of the comments that you left. So thank you very much for the flag. I will be putting that up today, hopefully. If it's not too windy, let's see what happens. Another job I need to do today is a tomato bottle challenge thing. But I'll show you that later as well. And if there's anything else to tell you and show you, I'll do that along the way. But for now, I'm going to finish my cuppa. So I'll see you in a bit. Right folks, as you can see, my tomatoes have now got the second truss on. So now the second truss is on, I'll be feeding twice a week. So I'm going to feed a little bit comfrey, I'll mix a little bit comfrey up. So it's a perfect opportunity to go and see what the comfrey is like that I made a few weeks ago on the comfrey video. It's ready now, well it's I've been topping it up. That's another load I've put in there, but if you can see in the bottom, I'll just get a poking stick. See what it's turned into? Horrible stinking liquid. So I've just filled up a bottle so I can mix up the right mixture. That's what it should look like. I filled that bottle up there. Horrible dark brown stinking liquid. Right, so that's one of them bottles of comfrey. Now I'll fill 10 bottles of water and put it into the bucket. So I crack on with that. Well, I had to find a bigger bucket because that bucket only held three of them. So I've emptied this water butt here and I've just filled it, like I say, one of these of comfrey, 10 water. And that's the perfect mixture of comfrey juice for the tomatoes. Speaking of tomatoes, and you would think I had just planned this, here is my tomato, which I'm going to plant up now for the bottle tomato challenge. Right, so here's my tomato for the bottle tomato challenge. That, I think it was Horty Hugh that set it up. Forgive us if I'm wrong, but I think it was Hugh that set this challenge up. So I've decided to take part. There is my tomato. Now this tomato plant is one of the mega bloom tomatoes, which I got off Dean. It's doing all right there. I potted it on a few weeks ago. It's getting some canny roots on there, probably. Just in time. So, since it's a mega bloom tomato, I've had to think of something, and I think I'm allowed to do this. There's me bottle. It's a mega bottle. It's one of them water dispensing things. So I filled it full of compost, which took some doing. That's full. So what the challenge is, you plant that in the bottle. Then you hang it upside down. I'll have to figure out a way of making a hole in the bottom so I can water. But I'm going to have to figure out a way of trying to hang this upside down. But for now, I'll just get on and plant it into the bottle. Catch yous in a bit. Woo, windy. So there it is, folks. Me hashtag bottle tomato challenge is complete. On to the next hashtag. Right, hashtag sunflower challenge 2020. Here are my entries. They're getting quite big, as you can see. There is a gap there. I've had my first disaster. Look at this. It snapped off, didn't it? I wouldn't care. It looked like it was going to be a canny sunflower. I feel a little bit sad. Poor thing. And what's happened is, and here's a tip for you folks, don't ever use this wire to support anything really with a, because what was the wind? Look at it, it's just a pure clean cut. The wind's been rocking it about and cutting it, and it's just snapped because it wasn't tied up here. So there's a little tip for you folks. Don't use that wire, it's bad. Just before I show you round, here's another hashtag for you. It seems to be all about the hashtags today. This is for the hashtag shedwars, hashtag teamoverthepond. Here is my bottle. Here's my potato tower in the tyres. And I'm just using grass cuttings here. Just grass cuttings. I haven't even watered. And they've come up there, canny. I'm onto my third tyre there now. And hopefully it'll be onto my fourth tyre. So it'll be interesting. So that's for the hashtag shedwars, hashtag team over the pond. I'll crack on, I'm gonna have a kettle. Yeah, I'm gonna have a cuppa first though. See you in a bit. Right, I've got my Columbo mat on for a reason. Just one more thing before I show you around. My potato here. This is one of the potatoes in the bucket, as you can see. It's starting to die off now. And I'm too eager to find out what's actually in this bucket. It's the purple eye seedlings. Be interested to find out what's going to happen. So, here we go, folks. first potato reveal of the year. Remember, this was just one seed potato in this bucket. Now, I've got some. The thing is, do I leave it a little bit longer? I think I will, folks. But there is potatoes there. Let's have a little delve round, see if I can feel anything with a good size. Yeah, that's not too bad. Aye, not bad, not bad. What I might do then, see if there's any other ones, and then just put it back in the bucket. So, I'll just leave that in there. I was just curious to see what these potatoes were like. Purple eye seedling. Okay, folks, I've done my little jobs for the day, so it's time to show you around. Start at the wildlife area, which is looking very wildlife-y. All of the cherries now are off the trees. They've either been eaten by the birds or they've blown away by the wind. Look at this hebe. It's absolutely covered. Nice big flowers on them as well. Very nice. It's huge this year. What a scene. There's the pond, there's frogs in there. I'm gonna get a load of blackberries this year by the looks of it as well.
I love blackberry and apple crumble.
Oh, he has the mock orange that started to flower. Quite nice. And that's also covered.
Very nice.
This, well, when I bought this, it was supposed to be a purple rose, but it's more like a pink rose. Still nice though, I've just been deadheaded and it keeps coming back. Nothing's been happening much here. I've got a few gooseberries on. My potatoes are romping away there. Be almost ready. I've noticed the flowers are on, so I've been pulling them off. If you don't already know that, it's a good idea to pull the flowers off. And I know some of you are going to say, well, farmers don't pull flowers off. But I bet you they would if they could. It's a bit different when you've got acres and acres of potato plants, but when you've only got a little bit of land, it doesn't take long to go around and take off all the flowers. It takes quite a lot of the plant's energy to produce a flower. And on a potato, a flower is not needed, because a flower is just there because the potato thinks it needs to reproduce, but it doesn't. So get rid of the flowers and you'll get better potatoes. While I'm here, I might as well show you the beans, the dead beans. I don't know what's happened to them down there. Like, these bolotti beans seem to have perked up though, which is good. There's that giant beetroot that's doing canny there. Aye, these potatoes will be ready to dig up soon. I love it, potato time. These peas from the gutter have perked up a little bit. And there's the ones that I sowed straight direct into the ground on the same day as I put the other ones in. I also put some in down here. And if you can see there, they're just starting to show, which is good.
my apple tree here, the Ergamont russet. It's got some canny apples on. And I was looking the other day, this pear tree. Oh, there's one pear on there I can see. All the rest seem to have fallen off. June drop. While I'm up here as well, I'll show you this mysterious, mysterious apple. It's definitely an apple-like. What sort it is, I don't know. The birds left this behind, so I just left it to grow. Got some quite good apples on there. First time ever. Right, oh, this clematis. That's starting to climb all over there. Great. The Swede. It's getting bigger. It seems to be getting et by something there, though. And there's a couple of gaps. But I've got some other ones I can replace them with. The leeks. They're all doing all right. And so are the potatoes. It's funny because these are the potatoes that I put in last. And they're much bigger than the ones that I put in first, which are these ones. But they're all seem to catch up the same. They're all looking the same now. So I've got some canny potatoes, hopefully, this year. There's a flower. Get off! There's loads of flowers. Onions, doing all right. Starting to swell up a little bit now. These shallots will be nearly ready soon. Starting to die back. The giant onions off Dean there. Doing all right. Bigger than the normal onions. The cabbages, while I'm here, the net's off. They're all doing fantastic. I'll just squat down here, folks. They're all doing fantastic. There's mini coal, cabbies, and January King, and they're all doing great. The two at the back there, the massive ones, they're the giants off Dean, and there's two giants that Gary, Jory Giant Veg, grew. In fact, I'll go around the other side, show you them ones. Sorry about that. My sunflowers are doing all right here. This one keeps falling over. I'll have to tie that. I was trying not to tie them on so they get a bit more of a thicker stem, but needs must. Right, can you see these cabbages from this side? Them ones there are the ones off, well, Dean gave us them, but Jory Giant Veg grew them. They're from his seed from last year. And that one there, and the one at the back there, are the ones off Dean, doing all right. So is this artichoke. These sunflowers here, I've just put them in. See what happens, they're getting the right good old battering by the wind there, but they're still standing up. And the artichoke is absolutely covered, as it always is. Look at that for a view. Right, I'll crack on. Oh, it's hard to jump over there. These, the bamboo's romping away since I put it in the ground. Don't worry, this is a variety that doesn't spread. It's called broadleaf. And it'll just stay there, it'll not spread. The loves lies bleeding.
Loves lies bleeding.
If you can see there, it's just starting to get a little flower on. There's another one there. The roses just keep on coming. But in the wind and rain, they don't last very long. But as long as you keep on pruning, they'll keep on coming. Annie's rose as well, that's getting a battering off the wind. And with these being little tiny roses, it's hard to deadhead. And not like disturb the ones that are all right.
But anyway, Annie's Lily. I don't know if you've seen this since the last video I made. It's starting to die off now, like, but it was 9 days late. It's nice today, isn't it? Apart from its coming to its end now. There's the wheelbarrow planter. It's looking all right. Whoa, windy! The sweet peas are doing fantastic here, look. Absolutely covered. Very nice, the dahlia as well. I don't think you've seen that. I'm just going to leave that in that pot from now on. What else to show you? These other potatoes in the bucket are still doing fine. That's the salt omira, and I can't remember the other ones. Aye, the sunflower. Bit gutted about that one, like, it looked like it was going to be a good one. Where is it? It's blew over. Now, Dean gave us some cuttings off his chrysanthemums, and the labels fell out. But these ones were yellow. And as you can see there, it's all from one, it's just one plant there. And the first yellow chrysanthemum has come. But, and I've never known this to happen before, ever, it's started turning different colours. That's not yellow. Or is it? I've been told a lie all these years. So that's a strange one for the books. Crack on. Aye, that tatey, I'll just leave it in the bucket. But I bet you that's the tastiest potato I'll ever have. Oh, look, the convolvulus has started flowering. But with it being a little bit windy and cool today, they haven't come out fully. But there they are, convolvulus. Right, get this greenhouse. Oh, that's better. The tobacco plants doing all right. I've got some others in the house which are bigger, because I had a feeling that it might be a bit too cold in the greenhouse, so I started some off in the house, and they're a little bit bigger than that, which is cool. The grapes are all just doing what they usually do, thickening up and all that kind of thing. It's absolutely covered there. You cannot see the trees for the grapes. So the experimental different pots will a work. Which one will be the best, do you think, folks? I'll put my money on this one. I think it'll be a good idea as well, because the root will be able to come out the bottom there, and you could even maybe just plant the whole thing into the ground. Who knows? There's no sign of any beans yet anyway, so I'll crack on. That's some the kale, the late sort of kale that needs to go out when it's less windy. The convolvulus of Dean just went to flower. Oops, look at the length of it though. Canny big. Right, so the tomatoes, I've given them a feed of comfrey there. So like I was saying, two trusses, feed twice a week. Three trusses, three times a week. And so on and so forth. Well, I'm getting some quite good bunches of, quite a lot of flowers on each truss there now. These are the sweet million. So that's fantastic. There's the bottle tomato. He has the cucumbers. Now this one looked as though it was dying off the other day, so I didn't water it. It seems to have picked back up. This one's doing all right. The one next to it though, that died off. So I have replaced it with a loofah plant. Let's see if I get any loofahs this year. This mini cucumber, there's one there, ready to pick almost. And there's another one. And then this other one just seems to have just stopped. But anyway, I've got enough for the new. Me peppers doing all right. Starting to get flowers on. So that's great. Just having a quick look round. The garlic is drying off there nicely. And it's amazing how the scapes like still keep on growing even though it's being pulled out the ground. Right, so anyway folks, that's it. That spinach round there. That's it for now. Thanks for watching, commenting, liking and subscribing and all that kind of thing. And I'll see you on the next one. Welcome to my new subscribers. I've seemed to have made quite a few since the last video. So, welcome. I hope you enjoy it. If you haven't already, please hit the subscribe button and the bell notification, whatever that means. And all that kind of thing. So until the next time, folks, take care, stay safe, and all that. Bye now.